Hey, this is Fafa Pico. You're watching Talk Dude with Ryan.
What's going on, everybody? Welcome back to another episode of Talk Dude with Ryan. And today, I'm going to be previewing the Union's match versus Atlanta. The big Eastern Conference semifinal game is here. And, Sunday's game was probably one of the most hype, if not the most hyped, Union game I've ever been to. It was just, like, such a cool atmosphere to finally see, like, a game that, like, means something. Like, obviously every regular season game means something, but this one just had, like, that sort of background and this value to the fans. That it was just such a cool environment, and I'm very glad I got to experience it in person. So, obviously, 4-3 win for the Union was a really good game. Red Bull did put up a good fight. The first half was actually... I really thought we were going to lose after the first half, and to be fair, Union did what they did do best this season, come back. So, the Union actually have been incredible at comebacks this year, so if we get down early in the first half tomorrow, which I won't be surprised with, there's always a shot at a comeback. And breaking down Atlanta, I've made thousands of Atlanta previews over my vast career of doing TalkTube videos, and you guys know, Josep Martinez, top 3 player in MLS probably, coming off of last year's Golden Boot campaign where he broke the record for most MLS goals, and, obviously Josep Martinez is an absolute stud, and obviously what he's best at is finishing, and his runs are very dynamic, very unpredictable, very choppy, where he stops at the box, then accelerates, and often gets on the end of a header or a cross, and he goes down easy. He's one of those strikers that you hate. I don't want to say flops, but he embellishes a lot of the contact he makes, and Atlanta gets so many penalties called for them. I know that last week was very controversial, where Matt Turner, touched his leg and he went down. But you know the kind of player Josep Martinez is. He's that guy that gets under your skin, the guy that can finish, the guy that just frustrates your team. So the key to tomorrow's game is just shut down Josep Martinez. If they can do that, we're probably in decent shape. Now, the weapons around him are obviously good. Justin Miram coming off of not a great season last year, but now he's coming back. Playing for Atlanta, and he's just had an incredible season, just a very resurging season back from when he used to play with the Crew. He's scoring, he's assisting, and he's a very good player for Atlanta. Ezequiel Barco, obviously, I don't think he's lived up to the hype when he was first signed, but still a very good dynamic player, can shoot, can pass, just very skilled player overall. Emerson Hyman, a guy that was hyped up with the U.S. Men's National Team. He's been pretty hot lately. But Atlanta is no joke on offense. They're good. But on the defensive side of things, they haven't been great, especially because they just lost. They have three of their three good defenders out. Breck Shea suffered that knee injury back earlier in the season. Miles Robinson suffered the left hamstring injury. And Michael Parkhurst went down in that last New England game with a shoulder injury. So that's three very good defenders that are out. So that means Paul Pogba's brother is going to have to step in. Leonardo Gonzalez Pires, who has been a staple to the Atlanta backline for pretty much their whole existence. So he's going to be back there. Obviously, he's a very good defender. So... Now, I think if the Union get behind them, they're not the fastest defense, especially because they play three at the back. If you can get Sergio Santos through, then I think we're in good shape, maybe playing crosses in. The key to tomorrow's game also offensively is just to get behind that back line. They play three backs. Obviously, they're without Miles Robinson, who is a very fast defender. So if we can play through balls in to Sergio, then him get crosses in, I think we're in good shape. Obviously, since Jim Curran said it's very unlikely Casper's going to play, then, we lose a finisher. But at the same time, I have faith in Sergio Santos and Andrew Vooten. Perhaps Fafa gets the start after his really, really good performance on Sunday. But lineup-wise for the Union, it's going to be more of the same. In fact, probably the same lineup, unless they go Fafa for Vooten. So that would be Wagner, McKenzie, Elliott, and Gaddis with Blake in goal. Then Harris, Bedoya, Montero, Aronson, Santos, and then Fafa or Andrew Vooten. To be honest, I like Vooten starting only because Fafa is that fast electric spark that the Union really did well with. To be honest, I really like the way Jim did the whole lineup on Sunday when he brought Elsino in, then he brought Fafa in, and then Marco Fabian, and then Juan Cravall. So if the Union are ahead, then bring in Juan Cravall probably as the first or second sub. But like I said last week, Elsino has to be the first guy off that bench. Elsino is just such a playmaker that we need it. And it could be the Union's last game of the season. It could be one of the last games in the Union season. So everything's on the line once more. It's another big game for the boys. Hopefully we can get it done. I do have confidence in the Union, but at the same time, we're playing at a very hostile environment where the Atlanta fans are very loud. They're very supportive of their team. And it's just going to be fun to watch. Like I said, it could be the Union's last game of the season, and it could be, you know, one of the last. So obviously, it's going to be one of your last times seeing the Union play this year, so enjoy it while it lasts. I'm very excited to watch the game. Let's just hope the Union get it done. That would be awesome. The Union actually have been pretty good against Atlanta this year. We even saw it. Sergio Santos, actually, he played very well against Atlanta, and I think maybe his presence tomorrow is going to be very good for the Union. I think that Sergio is key and essential to the Union's success tomorrow. Hopefully we get it done. I can't wait to watch the game. Thank you guys for the support this season if this is my last video. But hopefully it's not, and I'll see you guys next time on Talk Dude with Ryan.
I'm Alejandro Bedoya, and you're watching Talk Dude with Ryan.